Good morning. It's Thursday, June 27th. We were just floored by this letter that Walmart sent to their salmon suppliers in Alaska saying unless they agreed or the state agreed to partner with SFP, Sustainable Fisheries Partnership, they couldn't buy any salmon from them this summer. What floored us was that I think SFP is beginning to have a destructive role in American fisheries management. At least that's the danger that I see coming forward. Twice in the last month, SFP has told its partners not to buy fish unless there's a fishery improvement project in place from two fisheries in Alaska. One was pollock with the Bering Sea Canyons, and the second one now is Alaska salmon with Prince William Sound. Well, what's wrong with this? What's wrong with this? Why can't they give this advice? There's three reasons here. First, SFP has a massive conflict of interest. They're not only in the process of giving their retail partners advice as to which fisheries are sustainable, they're also in the process of selling the fishery improvement plans that make such fisheries sustainable. Secondly, the SFP is not transparent. When SFP issues rejects an American fishery manager recommendation, they don't necessarily go into where they disagree with the science or why they didn't participate in the process or why they're unhappy with the outcome. The Bering Sea Canyons is a good case in point. NOAA was very responsive about the issue of habitat in the canyons. Their scientists determined that there wasn't much of a difference between habitat in the canyons and on the rest of the continental slope. Given that problem, they wanted more time to address whether they should in fact impose fishing restrictions on the canyon, given that the habitat is not unique. SFP's response was to say to its buyers, its partners, don't buy Alaska salmon from this area without there being a fishery improvement project in place. Now in salmon, this whole salmon issue with the MSC has been a complete travesty. Alaska's withdrawn from the MSC, but they've not stopped managing their salmon. They have excellent management practices on salmon. Recently, as questions have arisen about Prince William Sound hatcheries and the impact on wild fish, the state of Alaska has embarked on a $5 million project to study the genetic interaction between wild and farm fish. This is equivalent to half the budget of the entire SFP organization, which is maybe $10 million. So what's happening here? SFP met with ASMI and tried to sell them on a fishery improvement project for Prince William Sound. ASMI presented a lot of technical data on what they were already doing and what the state was doing to address this problem, including the genetic study, the monitoring, and the other management improvements. And yet SFP would not accept that as showing progress towards the goal. And so they came back and said, without a fishery improvement project, we're not going to recommend any of our buyers participate in this fishery. So Walmart, which uses pink salmon extensively, was really left high and dry by this. So they wrote to Alaska and said, okay, we don't care the fact that you are in fact spending millions of dollars to address this issue. Unless you work with SFP, who's going to financially gain from that work, we're not going to buy salmon from you. This is plain and purely destructive to the American fishery management process. There's a reason the U.S. has the best recognized fishery management and most successful fishery management in the world. The reason is that there's a legal framework for open and transparent process, for public comment and response, and for the mandated legal requirement to follow scientific advice and to choose the best available science. Why does SFP and Walmart, in this case, think they should impose their own internal deliberations over this proven track record of success? We think there's a very big role for SFP in fisheries that are in trouble, in fisheries that do not have management plans, in fisheries where there's not the resources to create these kind of plans. But for the SFP to turn around and say to a major supplier like Walmart, only buy Alaska salmon if it's certified by us, if they pay us to be part of the solution to the problem, that's racketeering in my view. it is no different than one of Tony Soprano's garbage hauling contracts. I'm sorry to be so strong, but I feel incredibly angry about this because I do not think SFP is continuing to play a constructive role with these kind of advice to their partners. In Nantucket, Mass., this is John Sacton.